Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my YouTube channel. In the previous lecture, we have studied about the criteria for the stray current assessment. In this lecture, we are going to study about some of the design provisions in order to reduce the amount of stray current. In the previous lectures, we have seen these two formulas, that is the I stray is equal to the product of the track to earth conductance times the running rail potential. And running rail potential or the rail potential is the product of the current that is flowing, the traction current times the running rail resistance, that is the longitudinal resistance of the running rails. The design provisions which we are going to discuss are mentioned in clause 6 of EN 50-122-2. Now, in order to reduce the stray current, through this simple equation we can see either we have to decrease this, that is the track to earth conductance, or we can decrease the running rail potential, or we can decrease these both. So we try to do for both the cases. We try to decrease track to earth conductance by providing proper insulation between the running rails and the track slab or the deck reinforcement. So suppose this is your track slab and this is your running rails. So what we are doing, we are providing fastening systems which are having insulation pads. So with this insulation pad, you are reducing the amount of current entering from the running rails and entering into the reinforcement of the track slab. Apart from this, you are providing proper drainage. By providing proper drainage, you are limiting the water getting collected between the fastening system and the track slab. So if there is lesser amount of water, so there are lesser chances of the conduction of the current or the current leaking from the running rails and entering into the track slab. Apart from this, you can change the rail potential. You can reduce this value either by decreasing the amount of current, that is by bringing the two substations nearby, which we do not prefer, or decreasing the headway, or by increasing the headway, which also we do not prefer. The best method we follow is by decreasing the running rail resistance. This we can achieve by doing exothermic welding between the rail segments. So these are suppose the two rail segments. Instead of providing fish plates, we can do proper exothermic welding. Apart from this, suppose this is your up track and this is your down track. We provide cross bonds, that is between track to tracks and rail to rails. So these cross bonds will reduce the effective resistance by making the running rails parallel. Apart from this, even by this also, suppose we are not able to achieve the values. What we do, we provide an extra conductor that is known as the return conductor, and this return conductor is connected to these running rails. Now point to note this is that this conductor is insulated cable. This is not a bare conductor, and this is not same as the stray current collection cable or the structural earth conductor or the buried earth conductor or the tunnel earth wire. These three conductors are used for earthing, or sometimes we are connecting the stray current collection mat also to this. In the other cases, we are using this for stray current collection mat, and all this is not same. This conductor is different because these conductors are used for either equipment earthing and other purposes, but this conductor is only dedicated for the traction current. This is only for carrying the traction current, just like the running rails. So this is also insulated. The running rails also you are keeping insulated. Apart from that, the current that from these running rails has to go back to the source. So we are providing return cables so that those cables also shall be insulated. By providing complete insulation from this path, we are avoiding the current to leak and decreasing the amount of stray current. So these are some of the provisions mentioned in clause 6. But one of the most important provision that has been mentioned in this standard is that we shall keep this complete system floating. That means we shall not connect it to the earth at any point. Neither these running rails nor the negative bus bar, anything shall not be connected to earth. But this has a problem, because suppose we have a station, suppose this is your platform and these are your running rails, and suppose the train is standing here, and suppose a person is standing here and he is touching, or he or she is touching the train. So by touching the train, he is exposed to the running rail potential because it's completely metallic. So If the running rail potential is above the limit, that is 120 volts DC, this value is given in clause 9 of EN 50-122-1. This value is for the main line. For depots, it is 60 volts DC, and for AC system, it's completely different. So now, as we are talking about DC, suppose this value is 120 or more than that, this value can increase, that is the rail potential can increase once the current is higher or the resistance is higher. Now, resistance, you have said, you will say, I am not changing the resistance, how can resistance be higher? It can be higher in case of N minus 1 case. Now, let us suppose there are three traction substations and there are sections here. So this is feeding this section, this is feeding this, and this is feeding this. In case of failure, we extend the supply. Suppose this traction substation has failed, two has failed. So one will be supplying this supply and three will be also feeding. In this case, what will happen? The running rails, which are here, will also extend. Suppose now the train, instead of this section, is in this section. So the current will be going here, here, and from here it will be returning. So the running rail length has increased. Once the length has increased, the value of resistance has increased. And once the resistance has increased, the rail potential increases. And if it is going above 120, in that case, the person can get electrocuted or he can get an electric shock. So in order to avoid that, what we have to do? We have to do earthing. So let us do earthing at all the stations. That is simpler. No, the standard says that it has to be floating, so we have to keep it floating. But what to do for safety? In that case, what we do, we provide an extra device which is connected to the running rails. And this device is like a switch. And this is an intelligent switch. It is IGBT or a GTO. And this switch will trigger, it will turn on in case the voltage goes above the set value. So let us suppose you have set a value of 120 volts. So it will trigger and it will be connecting the running rails to the earth. And once the running rails voltage is decreased, then the switch will open and again make the complete system floating. Now by doing this, you are saving the person or improving your safety. But in case the person is standing here and the voltage is not 120, but some voltage like 30, 40, 50 volts, so then he can feel some jitters or he can feel at some tingling effect. So that also you have to avoid for the person's comfort. So in order to do that, what you do, you at this platform, you provide something called platform insulation membrane. So this is an insulation membrane. It is made up of bitumen, and this bitumen avoids the connection between the person's foot and the platform reinforcements. So suppose here there are reinforcement bars and there's a mesh here. This mesh is eventually connected to the earthing system of the station. So in case there is some voltage in this station earth mat due to fault or some other reasons, so there can be some voltage here. So if the person is standing here and if there is no insulation membrane, then this person will also have some voltage on its legs. So there will be some voltage here V1, and he is touching the train, then he will have some separate voltage V2. So there is a potential difference between his legs and hand. So there can be some amount of current flowing, maybe not equivalent to electric shock or getting him electrocuted, but there can be some tingling effect here. So in order to avoid that, we provide this insulation membrane. And this insulation membrane shall be for around 2.5 meters. Now why 2.5 meters? It is specified in IEC 60364-4-41NX-B3. That if a person is touching two objects which are exposed or which are having separate voltages, then the person shall maintain the distance of 2.5 meters. That means, suppose there is a person here, so he can extend his arm up to 1.25 meters here, and he can extend this also to 1.25 meters. So if there is an object here which is connected to separate earthing system and this is another voltage having separate earthing system, suppose 1 and 2, then there shall be a minimum distance of 2.5 meters so that he is not able to touch both the objects simultaneously. And also we shall remember, apart from this membrane, there shall be no equipment within this region. So there shall be no equipment here within 2.5 meters or if you are placing any equipment, if it is mandatory to place any equipment, then it shall be of voltage which is extra low voltage, and also this equipment shall have class 2 insulation. So it is important to have class 2 insulation. For class 2 insulation we'll be discussing separately, but remember that the priority shall be not to keep any equipment here. If you are keeping, then it shall be of very low voltage or it shall be of class 2 insulation. There shall be no earth conductor coming from the station within this region. Now apart from this, you have seen, this is voltage limiting device we are connecting. This voltage limiting device you are connecting either through the running rails, or you can connect it to the traction substation here, to the same bus bar, because this bus bar is eventually connecting to the running rails. But important point to note is that if you are having, let us suppose, 10 traction substations and you are having 13 stations, then the number of voltage limiting device shall be governed by the number of stations, because at each station you need to provide VLDO. In that case you shall procure this number of stations. In this case, if there is no TSS, then you shall avoid connecting to the bus bar. You can connect it and keep the voltage limiting device in the auxiliary substation in this station itself. And any further information for this, you can refer to NXF of EN50-122-1, and there are other product standards for this, that is EN50-526 series. So it is having -1, -2, -3. You can also refer for voltage limiting device. O is for operation. There is another device F, which is for fault, which we'll see later. Now I hope you have understood this concept. Now most important point is we are keeping the running rails floating. Why we are not keeping it earth, we'll understand in this slide. Now let us suppose we have two cases. This is floating and this is the earth case. So we'll understand first what will happen in the floating case. Now suppose the current is coming and the current is going back to the source, this load current. So there are chances, and there will be some current leaking due to imperfections in the insulation which we have provided. For some area it will be coming back to the source, and for some area it will be leaking. So for the area from where it is leaking is having positive potential, and from the area which it is going back is having negative. In between, let us suppose there is an equilibrium formed. So in between, this voltage will be zero. So that means that distance L by 2, let us suppose this length is L, where the train is standing, a train is there, and this is origin where the substation is there. So at L by 2 there is something called virtual earth. You are not providing any earthing here, but it is just virtual earth, as the potential is zero in between. Now if you understand, we'll see what is the potential here and what is the potential here through this simple circuit. So let us suppose this is your real potential, U R E, and let us suppose this is the circuit. So here this circuit is having resistance R, the remaining half will also be resistance R because it's same length, and this is connected to virtual earth. So this is not proper earthing. Let us suppose this is point C and this is point A and this is point B. For simplicity, I am writing this URE as 2V. So now suppose, let us see that the current flowing here is I. This I is equal to twice of V by 2R, because the circuit, if you see, is having resistance in series. So the current becomes V by R. Now potential at point A will be VA minus VC is equal to I times R, and here I is V by R. So VA becomes positive of V, as VC is 0. Similarly, if you calculate for VB, VC minus VB is equal to IR, but VC is 0, so minus VB is equal to V. So this becomes negative of V. So you see the potential is getting divided. So half of the real potential is on this section and half is here. In between it is 0. So if you plot a graph for this case, that means plot a graph between the potential and the distance. So you will see that at this point, at the origin, the voltage is minus V. At L by 2, the potential is 0, and at L, the potential is V. So if we draw, this will be a straight line. So only for this section, the current is leaking, only for this half. For the remaining half, the stray current is going back. So you see the area where the current is leaking on Z is only half of it, and also the potential that is coming is only half of the real potential that is causing the stray current. Now in case of Earth system, you will see something that suppose this is again distance length L, and suppose this is the same circuit, but however there is no virtual earth as you are providing proper earthing here. So the current will be leaking completely throughout this area and will be going back through this proper earthing which you have provided, because this is the least resistance path. Here there is no earthing, so the current has to go back on its own, but here you are providing a dedicated path. Okay, current, you can follow me. So from this path the current will go back to the system. So the area where the stray current is leaking has become doubled, nearly double. Now the potential at this point, let us suppose again 2V, so at A and B, so if you calculate, VA minus VB will be I times R, but here the R is double because it is 2R. Here it was in midpoint, here it is 2R. So I is V by R times 2R, so this becomes 2V. So potential at point A is now twice of V. This you could have solved even without doing this circuit, but I have just solved in order to make it similar. Now if you plot this graph, I'll plot it with the green for this case. Now if you plot a graph, we have 3 points again. We have 2 points here. At origin it is 0, and at L it is 2V. So if you draw, this will become a straight line. So you will see that the potential is getting doubled in this case, and also the area for which the current is leaking is also nearly double. Here the area was half. So you can correlate that the stray current for the earthing system, the earth system, is nearly, not exactly, but nearly equal to 4 times the stray current in case of floating. So that is why we prefer floating system rather than earth system. And in actual, this is not a straight line. In this actual, it is an exponential function, so it will be a curve, so which we will discuss in the next lecture. Apart from that, we will be discussing about the stray current collection mats and the complete earthing system. Now for this lecture, I hope you have understood why we are preferring a floating system instead of earth. So I hope you enjoyed this lecture. Please subscribe to my channel, and God bless you all.